My name is Aimi Rosli. I'm the second secretary spouse. I'm here from Brunei Darussalam, and I've been here for 2 years now. The origin of ambuyat, it goes way back. Back in the days when they are scarce of rice, they actually had to find another source of carbohydrate. So they actually, rumbia tree is found everywhere around Brunei. So there's a lot of forest in Brunei. So they need to find another form of carbohydrate. So they developed ambuyat. In Brunei Darussalam, it's pretty common. You can find it all throughout the year. Ambuyat is a traditional food that is being shared by family members. So normally when we have events, there will be ambuyat served. And usually in the setting where you sit in the floor, traditionally. But now you can actually eat it on like the table. There are also restaurants which serve ambuyat in Brunei, specifically ambuyat. So most foreigners, they actually just can easily find ambuyat in the restaurants right now. Once we've done the ambuyat, now we can move on to making the cacah and dip. Ambuyat is very unique in Brunei because for one, the rumbia tree is actually found in Borneo. I think it takes a lot of skills to actually process the ambulung, from how you extract the sago from the rumbia tree and how you actually drench in water and to actually extract the sago from the rumbia trunk. So the process there is very unique in a sense that it's very limited people who can actually know the process of extracting ambulung. I forgot to also mention that ambulung is the Bruneian term for sago. Actually, it's part of my childhood. Growing up, living in my grandma's house, I would see ambuyat being served by my grandma, my mothers, my uncles. So it will be in a setting like this, just on the floor in the kitchen, just eating ambuyat together as a family. That's how it represents Brunei as well. So when we actually eat ambuyat together, it signifies the close-knit relationship between family members and communities in Brunei.
So now we're going to show you how to eat an ambuyat. It's a traditional way of how Bruneians actually eat an ambuyat. We have a special utensil, a unique utensil. It's called a chatas. It's like a chopstick, but at the ends, as you can see, it's actually sealed at the end. So this is how we actually use to eat an ambuyat. So normally, in a traditional setting, traditionally we would eat it on a mat on the floor. And as you can see, there's the food here. So we've got the main dish, which is an ambuyat here. And then you have a variety of side dishes surrounding the ambuyat. It's not a must. It's also self-preference what you want to eat an ambuyat with. But normally, the cacah is there as the main side dish to eat the ambuyat with.
This is how we do it. Pull it like that and dip and eat.
Wow. It's your first time eating ambuyat?
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe you can tell us how you feel about it.
Okay. First, let me try first to do it.
What do you think?
It's tasty. The dip is so spicy, but it's yummy.
Usually we eat ambuyat during lunchtime, because it's a quite heaty food. In Brunei, we have big family, so we always have gatherings and we serve this as one of the special dishes. In fact, in Brunei, we have few restaurants that serve this special Brunei delicacy. And it's quite a popular dish also amongst the, not only for the locals, but also every time we have tourists to come to Brunei, we introduce them for this food and most of them like it.